Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can insert an item into a linked list. So basically, this video will tell you creation of linked list with the help of C language, right? So first of all, I am going to tell you how we can create a structure so that we can create node with the help of those structure, right? So this is a data type struct, then name of structure is node. Inside this, I am declaring a variable of integer type that will be info, and struct node pointer link. So basically, this type of structure, where the type of structure is also written inside it, is known as self referential structure. So this type of structure is known as self referential structure. So whenever you will be creating a memory block or you will be allocating memory with the help of the structure, so what will happen, it will be providing you two memory spaces. One is of type integer and one is of type struct node, and that will be a pointer that can hold address of another structure that will be related to this data type. So what will happen, it will create a node which will be divided into two parts. First part will be known as info, second part will be a pointer, and its name will be link. So through this structure, this node will be created. Now whenever you will be creating one more node, whenever you will be creating one more node, so basically it is known as node, node number one, this is node number two. So whenever you will be creating this node, so it will also be having info and pointer link. So what will happen, this node's base address or building address will be stored here. So for example, its base address is 1001, its base address is 2001. So this is the information or value part, integer type. This pointer link will be storing this. Let's say it is 20 and this will be having null. So this way, if you are on this node, so through this node link pointer, you can move to this node. If it is pointing to another node, so you can move to that node. So this way, basically the concept of linked list works. And to create these nodes, we need to use this type of structure, right? So now you might be thinking like how we can create these memory blocks. So for that purpose, you will be writing a function. So after declaring this structure, you can write a function, and name of that function will be get. Right? So get node is a name of function, its return type is struct node pointer. So basically, this get node function will be creating a node. This get node function will be creating a node, and this get node function will be returning the base address of this memory that is allocated through this get node function. Right? That's why its return type is struct node pointer. Now, inside this function, I am creating a node. One node pointer, that is struct node pointer t. Now I am going to allocate memory to this t pointer. So struct node pointer, for memory allocation I am using malloc function. Inside malloc I am passing size of, now size of struct node. So we need to create memory for this structure. So its data type is struct node, so I'm passing that. So size of will calculate total amount of memory required to this struct node. Then this memory will be allocated and its address will be typecasted into struct node pointer, and that base address will be assigned to t pointer. And then I can write return t. So wherever you want to insert a particular node at any position into linked list, whether it is first location or it is last location or in the middle of the linked list, Then before insertion, you need to call getNode function. GetNode function will be creating a node and it will return a base address with the help of this T pointer. Right? So this way we can create a particular node in C language. So I hope you understood this function. And malloc is used for dynamic memory allocation. So whenever memory is required, you can call this function. And internally, malloc will be allocating memory equal to the size of struct node. Right? So this is about getNode. Now we are going to discuss three things. So first, I am going to tell you how to write addFirst function. addFirst means every time, whenever you will be calling this function, the node will be inserted at the first position of the link. Second will be addLast. So in this case, we will be inserting node at the last position. And third will be addAfter. So in this case, we will be inserting a node after a particular position that is specified by the user. Right? So right now I am going to write the function for addFirst. So I am going to erase these things. So after implementing addFirst, again I will tell you how this linked list will be created. So now I am going to write addFirst function. So its return type will be struct node pointer. Its name will be addFirst. Let me write it from the beginning. So struct node pointer. Name of function is addFirst. It will receive parameter as struct node pointer. So it will be stored into start and the item that we are going to insert. And then here we need to implement the its definition. So I am erasing this as well. So let's assume it is written here. That is size of struct node. Right? So we are going to use this space, that's why I modified this. So now what we need to do, first we need to create a node so that we can insert that node into a linked list. And this addFirst function will be called from main function. So main function will be having a pointer of type struct node. So initially that pointer will be like this. So in main function you can create struct node pointer. Let's say its name is start and initially it will be having null. So we are passing that into this start pointer and item that we are going to insert. Right? Then struct node pointer new. So this is another pointer that will occupy memory. So now we need to call this getNode function. So new getNode. So this getNode function will be called, it will create a memory block. That memory block's address will be available to T. So T will be returning that address and that address will be stored into new. Right? So for example, let's say this is start and this is new. So new will be pointing to a memory block. Its base address is 1001. Right? So this way it is linked. So new is pointing to this memory block, which is divided into two parts, info and link. And it is storing into new. And start is null. Right? Now what we need to do? We need to insert this node into this pointer so that the new node will be inserted into our actual link. So before that, first we need to write if new equals to null. So if new is null, it means memory is not allocated, right? Memory is not available. So you can write printf overflow if memory is not available, or whatever message you want to display, you can write and add it to the return. So function will be terminated here only. and the remaining statement will not be executed. But if this condition is false, then it means memory is allocated and we can insert that load into link list. So first, what we need to do, we need to fill this information part. So you will write new info equals to item. Now again, you need to notice one thing. Whenever you access member of the structure through its pointer, so new is a pointer of structure type and info is the member of structure which is mentioned here. So if you want to access member of structure through its pointer, then you need to use this arrow notation. And how you can create this arrow? Hyphen and then greater than sign, right? So item, let's say item is 10. So this 10 will be stored here. Now what we need to do, we need to insert this node into this link list. So let's say this link list is blank. So in that case, this node will be first node and its next will be null, right? But if link list is already having some nodes, for example, it is not null, and if it is having one more node, so what will happen? Its address will be here. So what we need to do, we need to make this node as first node. So this node's address will be here and the address of this node will go to here so that it can become second node. So now we need to write the statement for this. So what I am going to do, new link equals to start and start equals to new. So this we need to do. So for example, its base address is 2001, which is stored here. This is a node which is already available into link list, and we need to insert 1001 node before this. So with this, new of link will be start. So start is having 2001, so it will move here, right? And new will go to start. So new is having 1001, so it will move here. So now start is pointing to 1001 and 1001 link is pointing to 2001. So this will be break and it will point to this and this will point to this. So this way you can see your node that you are you inserted right now at first position is now on first position, and the node which were implemented earlier and which was on first position, right now it is on second position. And this new is temporarily created in this function, so it will be of no use right now. And from here you can return start, because start is now pointing to new location, so you need to return the start so that it can be received in the main function. So this way I implemented at first logic. So I hope you understood how we can insert a node at the first position of the labels. So after this, now I am going to write a second method that is related to add last. So in that case, we are going to insert a node at the last position of the link list, right? So in this, we inserted first position. Now we need to traverse to the last position and then we need to insert the node, right? So I am going to erase this. So now I am going to implement second function that will be inserting node at the end of the link list. So for demonstration purpose, I already created this. So this is first node, base address is 1001, which is available to start. Second node, third node. So first node link is having address of second node. Second node link is having address of third node. Now we need to insert new node at this position, right? So return type is struct node pointer. Method name is at last, and it will be receiving two parameters. So struct node pointer start and int item. So item will be the value that we are going to insert. Now I am going to declare two pointers. First is struct node pointer new, and second one will be pointer, right? So new for creation of new node that is going to insert, and ptr for creating a new. So now new equals to get node. So this method will be executed, it will create a new node and its address will be available in the new pointer. So for example, this is new pointer, new node will be created. Let's suppose this its base address is 4001 and it will be available in the new. Now the address which is available in the new, we need to store in the link of 3001. So third node link will be having address of this newly created node that is right now available in the new. So before insertion, we need to check if new is double equals to null. So we can print overflow and return. Right. So if this happens, then this will be printed and your method will be terminated. If it is false, it means memory is available. So we already know this node will go to last location, right? So we can directly write two statements: new of info equals to item and new of link equals to null. Because this node will be placed at last position, so its link will be null and its info will be having the item. So let's say item is 40. So 40 will be stored here and this will be null with these two statements. Right now we have two options. First, if your linked list is empty, if your linked list is empty, it means you are inserting this node for the first time. So in that case, your start will be null, right? And second case will be your linked list is already having various nodes, right? So after this, we can check if start is equals to null. If start is equals to null, so we can directly assign the value which is available into new to start. So you can write start equals to new. So remember this, this is the case where your linked list is empty, it is not having any particular address. So we simply assign value of new to start. Now else, if linked list is not null, so right now in the case linked list is having three nodes. So now what we need to do, we need to traverse each node and we need to move to this location so that we can assign address of new at this location, right? So now I am assigning ptr equals to start. So start is pointing to 1001, so I have one more pointer, that is ptr. So ptr will be pointing to 1001. So for example, this is ptr and it is pointing to 1001, right? Now I am writing a loop while ptr link not equals to null. So if ptr link is not equals to null, then we need to iterate ptr equals to ptr link. So this is a loop which will repeat only this line, right? So right now ptr is 1001, its link is not null. So ptr will move to its link. So ptr is 1001 and its link part is 2001. So next time it will be having 2001. Now check ptr link, not null. So ptr link, so 2000 and its link is 3001, that will be assigned to ptr. So this time value of ptr will be 3001. Again check ptr link, so 3000 link is null, so this loop will be terminated. Right, so ptr is pointing to 3001, this node. Now what we need to do, we need to assign a new at this position. So we can simply write after termination of this loop ptr link equals to new. And remember one thing, while loop is repeating this line only, and this is separate from the while loop. After completion of this loop, this statement will be executed. Then you can close else part and at last you can return start. So So this way I explain you how you can add a node at the last position of the linked list with the help of this code. So again we use this getNode function so that we can allocate memory, and then with the allocation of that memory we inserted a node at the last position, right? So I hope you understood two methods now. First was add first and second is add last. Now we have third, add after, right? So before starting that, I'm going to remove this. Then we will be understanding that. So now I'm going to explain the concept of add after. So our third method is add after. So void add after. So this time return type is void because we are not going to change the start. So we don't need to return this to main function. And the parameters will be struct node pointer start int item and int position. So position will be the node. After that we need to insert a new node. So let's say position is 2. It means after this node here we need to insert a new node, right? And in previous method where I created new node which was pointing to 4001, right? So this was the case and its address was 4001. So I didn't mention this will be holding the address as 4001. So new will be removed because new was created into that function only. So now when we assign 4001 into this location, so it means this location is pointing to this, and this is the fourth node and it is containing null in the link. So here linked list will be terminated. So this way we can connect that. So now what we need to do, we need to insert new node between these two nodes, right? So again I need to create new node and I need to put that node's address here in between so that that can be inserted in between two nodes. So now I'm going to write the statements for that purpose. So struct node pointer new and pointer media. So these two pointers I created, right? Now integer variable I for I equals to 1. So I is initialized with 1 and here I am assigning media with star. Then condition will be I less than position. So if I is less than position, then this loop will be true. Then increment I plus plus and PDR equals to PDR link. So I will be incremented by 1 and PDR will move to next row. Now inside this, if PDR double equals to none. So let's say in this link list we have 4 nodes and you mentioned position as 5. So in that case PTR will be pointing to null position at a particular time because fifth node is not available. So if PTR is null at any point of time before moving to a particular position that we are searching here, so you can write a printf no search location or position, and then you can write data. So this is the loop through which we can move to a particular position after which we are going to insert a particular node. So let's say position is 2 and PTR equals to start. So this is PTR, it is having 1001, which is start. Position is 2, I is 1, so it is true. PTR is not null, so I will be incremented, I will be 2, and PTR will be having PTR link. So PTR is 1001, its link is 2001. So PTR will be pointing to 2001. Then I will be 2, so this condition will be false. It means finally PTR is pointing to 2001. So PTR is pointing to 2001, it means after this node we are going to insert a particular node, right? So now after this loop, what we need to do? We need to create a new node to get node. So get node will create a new node. So let's suppose this is new. This is our new node. Its base address is 5001, which is available into new with the help of this. And here you can check if new double equals to null. So again, you can write printf overflow. So I already explained you this why we implemented add first and add last. So if memory is not available, sufficient amount of memory is not available, then new will be having null. It means new node is not created. So you can write printf overflow and you can terminate your method here. Now, first we need to fill this and then this. So I am writing new arrow info equals to item. So item, let's suppose 50 that we need to insert. So 50 will be stored here, new of info. So new is pointing to 5001, its information will be 50. Now this node will be inserted here. So what we need to do, this node will become third node and this will become fourth. So this fourth node address will be here and this will become third node. So its address will go to second node's link part. Right? So right now this node's address is available here and we need to shift it here. So PDR is pointing to 2001. So through PDR link we can assign that address into link of new. So you can write new link equals to PTR link. So PTR is pointing to 2001. 2001 link is 3001, which will store here. And this position is new link. So new link is now pointing to PTR link, that is 3001. It means this node will point to 3001. Now we need to place this node's address here so that this will be connected to the link list. So this location is PTR link and we need to assign new here. So PTR link equals to new. So new is having 5001 and here PTR link will be having 5000. So this node is disconnected. So 2001 link is 5001. So it will move here. After this, we are on 5001 and 5001 link is 3001. So it will move to this. So this way you can see this node is inserted in between this. After second position, so this is third node, this is fourth node, and this is fifth node. So this way your third method is complete, which is add after. So we inserted a new node after second node with the help of this node. So this way I hope you understood all three methods, like how to insert a node on first position, how to insert a node at the last of the link list, and how to insert a node in between the link list. So this way I hope you understood all three methods that I implemented in the C language. Now if you want to watch how we can implement all three methods including get node and this structure and with the help of main function, so if you want to watch that complete program, so that program is available in another playlist that is related to DSA implementation using IDE, Integrated Development Environment. And the link of that playlist is available in the description of this video. So you can open that playlist and you will find a video related to complete implementation of linked list with the help of IDE. So watch that, where you will learn how we can execute this complete method. So this was the board explanation and that will be implementation of IDE. So if you want to watch that video, you can go to the description of this video. And if you want to watch algorithmic implementation of these three, add first, add last, and add after, so that playlist link is also available in the description of this video. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video.